Hello and welcome to the Super Casuals. My name is Ornato, and today we're playing a special edition of Classic Corner, playing an old Super Nintendo game called Gundam Wing Endless Duel. This is one of those gems that was never released in the West. The only way for us to play it nowadays is through the use of emulators and ROMs. I came across this game, 10, 15 years ago, back in my major emulator days. Had lots of fun with it. It's lots of fun. It's also made by the same company behind Dragon Ball FighterZ. I'm going to play the story mode today on normal mode. And I'm very, very rusty at this game. Haven't really played it much in, 10 plus years. So you'll forgive me if I'm not super awesome at it straight away. It has the 5 major characters. Can't for the life of me remember what the character's name was, but he has the Sandrock, he has Heavy Arms, Wing Zero, Death Scythe, and we didn't call it Shenlong in the West, but that's what it got translated to for whatever reason. There's the V8, Mercurius, and Talgeese. I'm going to play as Mr. Zex, piloting the Talgeese. By far and away the fastest of all the Gundams available to us. Let's dive in and have some fun, starting off against Death Scythe. This has a dash mechanic, very different from most fighting games. You can actually, if it would work for me here. There we go. Dashing backwards, you can block. You can charge block, throw. Having some trouble getting it to work on the ground here. I don't think I found a very good ROM. There's been some graphical glitches with this, but oh well. Otherwise, it's kind of neat. You can jetpack around. Do lots of neat stuff. You'll see you have a secondary energy bar, that yellow one with a number next to it. That's used for special moves. If you use the weak version, you just do the special, doesn't cost any meter. If you use the strong version, you'll glow and it uses 100. Come on. Ah! It's not cooperating with you. I'm trying to hit one. Okay, that's the normal version. Every time you hit a bad guy or block an attack, you gain some energy back. You can also use it for that pistol gun if you're far enough away. Unlike most fighting games, you can actually whack people on the ground. Kind of a rude thing to do, but I'm horribly out of practice at this. That's the first mission done. By mission, it's a fight. They call it missions, whatever. I have no idea what they're saying. I'm not interested in going out of my way to get a translation mod. Here we go. Next up. Boom! There are super moves. That's mine. You blocked it like a jerk. Stabba stabba. Boom! Oh yeah, I got a gun. Yeah, I've got a Hadouken-style super move. Bring up my gun. I can do that in the air as well. Fire down. Beep, 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 beep. There's a lot of dirty stuff you can do when you're fighting against human opponents. This game does have chip block, so if the opponent blocks at low health, they'll still die. Just trying to remind myself of some of the mechanics here. I haven't played this in ages and ages and ages and ages. And a lot of stuff does not work the way it does in Dragon Ball. Bear with me. It's alright. It's only on normal. It's not until we fight the last three or four robots that be any kind of challenge. Talgeese is the only one that can float down that slowly. Everybody else goes down to the earth pretty quick. Two very ineffective supers just now. I missed. Ow. Heavy Arms is the slowest of all the mechs, but he can do incredibly damaging combos. Most dangerous at a distance, despite the fact that he's a big tank. Gotta keep remembering I can hit people on the ground. Habits from Dragon Ball Fighters are kicking in here. I'm letting people sit down and going right into the air. I'm playing way too much of that game. Actually quite hard to hit some of these things. You can actually block that one. It's a command grab that can be thrown. Blocked rather. Command grab that can be blocked. Ow, 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 ow. Ow! Boom! Yee-pee. Yes! Stab him good. Tall Geese is so dangerous just because of how fast he can jetpack around. He doesn't have the best neutral game in the world, but he's just good at zipping around and screwing with people. Okay, Sanrock is another tank. Unlike Heavy Arms, this guy's actually much better close up. He's got a command grab as well. This guy is just standing here. I don't know why. Say that and he throws me. He's got a projectile that goes through most projectiles. Did that a little high, though. Yeah. Boom! Throws in this game do a lot of damage. Not a whole lot of really fancy combos. When you hit people, you both get knocked away from each other. It's really only Heavy Arms that has the really super long ones. Yeah! There goes Sanrock. He did not give me much of a fight. That's okay. Who's up next? Who's up next? Who's up next? Wing. Okay. It's our first time facing this. Later on, we got to fight Wing Zero. Boom! Don't think so. Everybody has an air grab. Sometimes, depending on who your character is, you can actually combo from a throw directly into a hit. Gotta stop doing that. I have the advantage when I knock somebody down. I should not be sitting there and let them sit on the ground without whacking them one more time. Once upon a time, the ZSNES emulator was quite popular, and we had a online gadget that allowed us to face people online, which is pretty cool considering. Great for games like Mario Kart, or this, or Street Fighter. Ow, ow, ow! But, I don't really think the community of that... I don't think there's much of a community for that one anymore. Oh, he outranged me. Wing's got some pretty long pokes. Has a beam saber weapon that's really, really powerful, too. He didn't use much of it in that round, though. Unlike most fighting games, actually, whatever resources you had actually carry over from round to round. So if I burn all my special meter, I will start the round with none. You can charge in for a safer approach. However, you are vulnerable to pokes from the ground. Yeah. Boo, get out of here. That's one of the space colonies in the background. This doesn't seem to be any rhyme or reason to the stage order that just does stuff. V8, the lady with a big gun. Big old gun. Has potentially the most damaging super in the game. If you get caught at the wrong angle, it hits twice more than it's supposed to, and it just does stupid amounts of damage. And I can potentially hit 12 times instead of 6. And the AI for this thing just loves to jump around. That's all it does. Ah! So rude! Ow, 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 ow! See, that was one of the bad angle ones. Funnily enough, I can actually do that too. At the right angle, my super does way, way, way more damage. That is not the right angle. Neither is that. You cannot do your charging advance while in the air. You can only do that on the ground. Do not have invincibility during your specials, you can absolutely get poked out of it. I didn't even mean to do that just now, but whatever. Powerbomb that woman. Next up is the Mercurius, which is the second most annoying out of all the mechs. Especially in the hands of a computer, this thing just spams its long-range multi-hit pokes. And trying to approach from the air is very dangerous. It has the best Shoryuken in the game. Basically down heavy straight out of Dragon Ball FighterZ. And the computer loves to use it. Ow. Ah. Okay, Mercurius is getting smashed pretty good here. And there's two more robots after. Wing Zero and the quote-unquote hidden mech. And well, I'm not going to spoil who that is. Mercurius has the disadvantage of having a hard range limit on her special. If you're full screen, it will not hit you. She also has an energy shield. Stops almost all damage as long as your energy lasts. Drains pretty quick when the shield's up. It takes a long time to activate. You're very vulnerable while trying to put it up. Next up, we'll have Wing Zero. One of my least favorite of all the mechs. I prefer the original Wing, honestly. The stats that you saw at the character select screen don't actually matter. They don't make any real difference. Ah, I ran into that. Some characters have light attacks that can hit the ground. Tall Geese is not one of them. So Wing Zero can go in there and kick you in the face a few times, or if you're facing the wrong direction, you can just kick you in the shins. Peter gets up faster than any human can. It's actually quite obnoxious. Ah, he went for his super. Whoop. Oh, can I do that again? I can't even remember. Burn up. Yeah, you can do a second one, but you have to go up first. So what you can do for mix up, go ahead of them, if you cooperate and let you do it. Go up. Go behind. He's being a jerk here. Ow, ow, ow. Oh boy, ow. Oh no. His guns shoot more than my guns. He has two guns, actually. He fires twice. Spending too much time trying to do that fancy tech. So go up, go behind. And I screwed up the input. And teleport backwards. Teleport. Up. Ah, I landed right on that. How did that not hit? Get out of here. Ow! You might lose this one. Yep! I got destroyed. Spending too much time trying to do fancy stuff for the camera while I'm in the middle of the second highest computer dude here. Nothing fancy for a game over screen. I'm just going to pick Tall Geese again. Doesn't really matter. Okay, let's do this again. Up. I really got to get a better controller. My PlayStation controller is giving me all kinds of trouble. One of the reasons I want to stop playing Dragon Ball for a while. Who needs push block when simply hitting people gets you knocked away? Ow! Yeah, you can do your charging tackle Shoryuken thing mid-air. Well, it's very, very, very unsafe. It does not stop incoming projectiles, as you just saw, so he poked me through it. Shield pokes. Very, very slow jab, not very good. Okay, Wing Zero got squashed. And the hidden character, Epion. But normally piloted by the guy I'm using now, but because I'm using Tall Geese, it's Hiro Yui inside. This is the most annoying character in the game. One of only two robots capable of an infinite combo. Not that the computer will do it. But it does absolutely stupid amounts of damage. That super is the most overpowered thing in the game, does almost half your health, and recovers a ridiculous amount of energy, so you can just spam it over and over and over, even if the guy blocks it. That tackle thing does ridiculous amounts of damage, too. Very safe. Ah! Okay. Epion does stupid damage. Very, very dangerous, especially in the hands of a computer that will just input read you like crazy. Just does whatever, you have no idea. The only thing you can really hope to do to stop that tackle is to just block it and hope you can throw without them teching after. Ow! If you get caught by it, say hello to a lot of damage. Tall Geese has probably the worst out of all the supers, not just how boring it looks, but it really doesn't do all that much damage. Even if you catch it with that way of getting it to do more, it still doesn't do all that much. He's a mobility character first and foremost. Ow! Yeah, stop this super with mine. Immediately got wrecked. The tackle is projectile immune. Oh no, oh no, oh no. Yes! Magic pixel! This game, the magic pixel isn't even a pixel. I had zero life left. Oh boy. GG, Epion, GG. It's a pretty decent sprite art. I have no idea what it says. Not really important. If you beat the game on hard, it tells you how to use Epion, though you can't use him in story mode. Anyway, I'll let this play. You can enjoy the pretty cool background music that plays. Music in this game is actually quite good. I thank you for watching the Super Casuals. I was Orinato. Remember, keep it casual. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe if you'd like to see more.